Disclaimer notice. This video is for entertainment purposes only. If you are unable to follow the instructions in this video or are uncomfortable with basic wiring, please have this modification performed by a qualified electrician or technician. Electrical wiring is no hobby. First thing you need to do is locate the nameplate. When you find the nameplate on the side of the box that covers the fan, you'll see all the information you need to look up the part and order one. This is a model PR4 Ventline. Okay, here's the new motor. It's right from Amazon. We all know that instructions are not needed, but the motor comes shipped with a complete set of instructions and illustrations. So, just in case you do need to refer to the instructions, I'm including them in this video. Rule number one is, obey all rules. If you have decided to replace this motor, no matter whether you are a beginner, a homeowner, or an electrician, the first thing you need to do is disconnect power from the range hood at the fuse box or circuit breaker panel before beginning motor replacement procedures. Pay close attention to the wiring before you remove any wires or cut them. This way, you will be able to connect the wires back to the place where they came from. Most likely, the fan is going to be pretty cruddy, so you need to take it off and wash it and clean it with soapy water. The fan blade is attached to the shaft of the motor by a spline on the shaft. You have to hold the motor in one hand and pull and slightly wiggle until you can pull the fan blade off. Be careful not to break it. Here you see the old motor and the new motor, and of course, these many years later, they've replaced it with a two-speed motor, but that's not a problem. I only have a switch for one speed, so I will not be hooking up the slower speed. And it comes with instructions if you need them. As I mentioned, the new motor has three wires. Blue is for low, red is for high, and the white is the neutral. And just as the old motor had, you got a spline that the motor fan mounts on. It just pushes on. You take the motor and the spline, line it up like so, and push down. When you put the fan blade on, make sure that you put it on the same way it came off of the old motor. And then when you tap the hub on, it's going to be pretty stiff, but just go until you get flush, or just about flush. These two studs, threaded studs, are your mounting devices. This is what holds it on to the fan housing. This did not come with nuts, so take the nuts off of the old fan motor.
Have to take them off. And put them on the new motor. Now, once you mount the fan, this is what it looks like. You have two holes to put the bolts through and put the nuts on. That's all that holds it in. And just make sure it's centered good so that your fan blade is not touching anywhere, that it's free to turn. Now, you notice there's a lot of rust on this, and this whole unit really needs to be replaced. But right now, with the inflation and the cost of gas, we're just going to get by for a while with this new motor. And then when things straighten out, we're going to replace this whole unit, the whole vent hood,